My name is Neofytos Solomonidis. I'm an electrical engineer and I'm working for Lifestyle Technologies, Karayonis TechnoPro, the sub brand, and I'm working as a lighting engineer. The company is Smart House department, and I'm working in the lighting engineering specialty. We are specialized in designing and covering the lighting panels that will work on the smart house, that are working with our systems.
Okay.
And I'm going to the inspections with the electrical authority, and it's my responsibility so the lighting panels work properly, so our programmers can come and program the house program. I've heard by accident about this department of job. It was only the classical electrical part I knew about in Cyprus. So when I learned about that company from a friend of me that was working with me at that time to another company, I said, yes, I have to try this because something different, it's more specialized thing than the classical electrical department that you are designing house or installations and those kind of things. We're going at work at about 8 o'clock, not about 8 o'clock. We are usually, in the day that we have to do an outside work, we're going to the office, take our plans out that we have made from another day. And we're going to the construction site that is nearly finished with the electrician, and we're starting to checking the panels about the if they are okay, if they have any issues and those kind of things. If we are working on the office, we are usually designing the panels so we can send them to the panel constructors to construct those panels with our machinery in it, which need a specialized wiring. So we have to design it in the AutoCAD program. Mm-hmm. So we are splitting our times inside for the designing and outside to guide the electricians, about how they are going to install our things, how they are going to connect them to their electrical construction there, and those kind of things. I was studying at University of Patras as electrical engineer, and before I finished my degree, I started working somewhere else. It was near my field, but it was a service in a big brand company here in Cyprus that was giving telephones, many electrical devices. And while I was working there, I learned about this, and I took the, because before I knew about, these kind of companies, I thought that only electrical engineers is doing designing, house implementation, those kind of, mm-hmm. and this. Maybe I will choose a bit more, not so technically route, more theoretically route. For example, more programming and these kind of things. But still, my job has a lot of interest. There is a lot of technology to learn, new things to learn every day. It's something that is evolved day by day, so we're knowing new things. But the only difficulty is with the construction sites here in Cyprus. The have many trainings and many seminars that happens either in Cyprus for some of the things that some of the protocols that we are using in our automations, and many more that in the which you can do online from the providers of the of our systems, because you need to know to be more specialized than you can learn from anything else. So they, yes, you have to do many seminars and many to go to conventions to learn many things. No, I learned from when I started to be employed. Before that, I didn't know nearly anything about automation and this. I learned by working. Some of them, yes, the technicians usually are finished from technical schools. No, they don't have, don't need to have degrees or something else. And most of the people that are working there, yes, have an educational level of university and this level of. The main educational thing, you have to know the basic of electricity. You have to know the regulations of Cyprus on the power consumptions and power protections and those, etc. And for personality, you have to be very careful and very on the spot. Not make many mistakes, because your mistake is probably some of your equipment going to be destroyed, because we are working with high voltage power, and you have to know for everything about electricity, so you don't have any dangers, and for yourself and for your colleagues and for the customers. Of course, and not as so much with your colleagues, because your colleagues are going to be in the similar level with you, but because in my department we are working a lot with electricians that are not in our, they are practical people. They are not usually, they don't have the education background to understand some things. You have to be very communicative to understand how they understand the electricity and make them learn about your systems and how your machinery is working, and why we want to make these kind of connections with their educational background. So you have to be flexible and very communicative so you can work with them. With the skills that I acquire now, it's a little bit difficult because it's very specialized. This, because as an electrical engineer, I have many options to work somewhere else, but with the skills that I acquire from this job, it's very difficult to work somewhere else except from construction sites and construction implementations, because it's specialized only on this. You can work a little bit to the industry because the automations are similar, but you are a little bit a narrow path. Usually you have a lot of pressure about the ending of the project. You have the constant rush that, and because usually it's not in our control, the time schedules of the project. We are the last people that are working on a construction site. We have the pressure that if the delay was someone else, we have the pressure to finish it on time without having our time that we asked about in the beginning. And then we have the, in the middle of the day, maybe they call you to go somewhere else urgently to, and it's making your day a little bit unpredictable. For example, you have a plan for a week, and the second day usually is not going to work because something else urged, and they have to go there to do something else and leave the others thing back to for another day. Mm-hmm. So usually our main challenges is with the pressure we have from the projects. Of course, some accidents happen with the electricity, but usually not an accident that harm someone else. Usually our machinery are going to pay the price, but. Technical and careers have a lot of interest. The horizons are too wide, and you have to learn many things so you will not be narrowed to only one path. The good thing with the electrical engineering, chemistry, chemical engineering, all kinds of engineering, is that you don't have to, of course, in your job you're going to be more specialized, but you don't have to be specialized yourself. So it's good to learn more things and use fewer, the fewer you can use. But it's better to be more widespread. And there is a lot of problem solving. It's exciting for this kind of thing because you are solving, usually as an engineer, you have to solve things that is everyday things, and somebody has to solve them. So it's one of the first things that they learn us in the university, is that you are engineering, you are solving problems. That's your job. And it depends on what path you are taking, you are solving those kind of problems. And you have to be careful, you must be observer. For teachers, you have to be a little bit, have to observe if the kids have mathematical or so problem solving brain, because our brain is working different to everyone. They have to push them to go to more scientific approach and less theoretical. Mm-hmm. Less theoretical, because some brains are made for more practical approach. These brains must be working on scientific departments. And it's good if the parents see that their kids are interested in these kind of things. They are like solving problems, or maybe they want to fix some equipment in the house, mm-hmm. and they want to have interest on this. They have to push them to go to these kind of jobs, because they are going to love them and be more happy and more productive in these kind of jobs.